So, what's up, guys? It's Ricky. Hey, this shot is making me look awesome. This is really looking awesome right now. On this particular episode, we are going to talk about a recent expose video done by a guy who exposes fake forex traders. And he did a recent video not long back, I think a week or two back, on a guy by the name of Ralph Wayne. And so Ralph Wayne, you'll remember that there was a little shenanigan that he had done with Bushiri. And I want to talk particularly about this phase where there was a lot of focus on promoting this trading and whatnot towards churches. And I'm going to talk mainly on two particular individuals, Ralph Wayne with Bushiri and also Prince Maziboko, who is Ricky the Zurich Reality Show. We do daily Christian commentary videos. And so if you didn't know these particular two individuals, they were forex traders slash crypto people slash whatever entrepreneur thing, but they were very pushed, they were a lot more pushed as people who were young, people who were successful business people. At one particular point, Ralph claimed that he was a billionaire, he had over half a billion and so forth. Now, he had started something called Pipcoin, and Pipcoin was running around the same period when Bitcoin was starting to become a publicly known subject. And by that time, he claimed that, you know, this thing, he started it or whatnot. If you go back to the interviews back then, you would hear him saying that he started this thing. He felt the need to respond via audio, threatening to sue him and so forth. A really great video. So you can go check the video out on Randall's channel. I'm just starts threatening the guy that he will destroy him. He has connections west, left and right. Person who is claiming that he is connected doesn't say it. They don't have to say it. You either know it or else. He claims that he's taken down people, he's destroyed individuals, whatnot, don't care for it. But he takes that charlatan route of thinking that they are invincible and brings that to the forefront. And then he then questioned him on the issue of, you know, can you prove that there is payments that were made directly to him? Yeah, you can go watch the video over there. But it was very interesting when it was pushed to the people at ECG, when it was pushed to people out there. If Bushiri was really a true prophet, would he have not known that this thing was not stable to actually go to a collapse? As a matter of fact, Ref himself in that particular audio actually goes on to say that the thing just didn't work out, okay? And so it didn't work out. Why? It was not registered, none of that stuff. It didn't have all the systems that were needed by that time in order for it to be fully a cryptocurrency or a crypto coin, blockchain, all that. It didn't have all these technologies behind it. And so fascinating that they pushed it as something that he started. And now he's like, no, it was just a peer-to-peer system, whatnot. You can go listen to the audio over there. The second person, Prince Maziboko, and was highly connected with a lot of pastors. He kind of dabbled into some form of preaching. You know how they can act like preachers and honk their voice and kind of take the personality of what they see from other preachers and all that kind of stuff. He used to do that when he was talking to Christians. He would go to churches bragging about how rich he was and how much money he was making and how much money he was going to make them. There's a lot of churches that fell into that. A lot of pastors pushed him to their members, and as a result of that, a lot of people lost their money. Now, how many people lost their money? We don't know. Dare we say there is a lot of people that I've heard throughout Richards Bay, whatnot, all that kind of stuff. I remember when I was still very majorly in the forex space, it was a very heavy subject to say how many people exactly are involved. There was a lot of systems that were going up and down between him and a lot of churches. And one day maybe they will come out and speak and we'll hear what exactly happened or what exactly they were being promised. But a lot of pastors pushed these people as if they were legit. Some of them claiming to be prophets. Could they have not seen what was wrong with these individuals, that these people didn't have the credibility that they claimed to have? Now, on here, I'm just questioning that part only. Everybody else can make up their own mind and make their own decision. Personally, these things were pushed as authentic to people. These individuals were pushed as authentic individuals. And now they are now abandoned. There was also another video that Randall also made where he's actually putting up a video where Prince Masivo, the very same gentleman, is talking about how brokers can give people fake accounts and all that kind of stuff. And so it's very questionable to say, what if he, how do we know that he didn't do that? Because he said, as long as you were connected to the broker would directly give you that access to make a demo account look like it was live, and therefore pushing people into the stream. And how you would only be able to actually illustrate it is that they only show blue screens of people being profitable, but they never show withdrawals or any of this kind of stuff. But to each man his own, every man's finances to himself. But for me, it's the one of Prophet Bushiri and Ralph Wayne, where he claims that this is something that is legit, its own thing, and the prophet could not tell that this thing was going to fail, and this is the man that is supposed to give you your prophecy about your future and all that kind of stuff. I think people are extremely delusional. Now, this video has nothing to do with Ralph Wayne. This video just only speaks about the pastors that were pushing these individuals to their church members, and right now, a lot of people are in deep pockets and deep debts because they have never recovered. There are people that have never recovered from the debt that they encountered with these individuals. It's Ricky's The Reality Show. We do daily Christian commentary videos. I just wanted to kind of highlight those particular two cases, mainly the Ralph Wayne and the Prince Mazibuko. Prince Mazibuko was mainly pushed as a Christian. One was pushed as a Christian who was successful as a young person before the church, and a lot of people went in to do business with him whichever way. But Ralph Wayne, never a Christian, he calls himself shaman, and I mean, like, if you go and look up what a shaman is, I don't know how a prophet was associating his people or his audience with that kind of an individual. But this video has nothing to do with this particular individuals. It has questions to do with the pastors that were promoting them to their church members. Yeah, tell me what you think. It's Ricky, and I'll see you on a later on. Other videos done today, down in the pinned comment. Salute.